Auto HVAC Condenser Fan Circuit. The automotive HVAC condenser fan circuit is in charge of extracting heat from the refrigerant outside the vehicle by blowing outside air through it. It is placed at the front of the car, inside the engine bay, right behind the condenser unit and radiator. In many models, it is separate from the radiator fan motor. The condenser holds compressed refrigerant. The circuitry running the condenser fan is also as important as the rest of the system. The main difference is in how the fan motor is actuated. Here are the different circuit variations. But before we go into it, there's one fact that you must always remember when analyzing on a computerized climate control HVAC system, which is that the engine computer, or ECM, always reserves the right to control the condenser motor and compressor clutch. This we'll call the golden electrical rule of automotive HVAC. Type 1 connection. The condenser fan is triggered by a relay. This relay is activated from the AC, controller button, and the ECM. In this diagram, the relay is connected to 12-volt power through a fuse. The relay coil is tied to power through the HVAC control knob. The other side of the relay coil is tied to the ECM, which gives it a ground. Now, why is it done this way? On all modern climate control systems, the ECM reserves the right to perform the final on-off decision. This is due to the fact that the compressor clutch puts a power load on the engine. Whenever the refrigerant compressor turns on, so does the condenser fan. This means that during wide open throttle and certain other engine conditions, the ECM will keep the compressor and condenser fan off. This is the golden rule of automotive HVAC. Type 2 connection. The condenser fan, if turned on, also by a relay, but two other devices can turn it on, as long as the control switch is on. In this case, the ECM and the AC thermostat, this sends to be an older system, but it's still used. Only the AC thermostat is now of an electronic solid state type. This circuit arrangement puts the decision making on either the thermostat or the ECM. Type 3 connection. The fan is activated by the ECM and the AC control module, or HVAC head, as it is called. This is now the most common system. It works by sharing the decision by one or the other, and the ECM keeping the final say on the on-off process. How does this happen? As you can see, the ECM is also tied to the HVAC computer, and it will not actuate the condenser fan motor unless it gets the okay from the ECM. Again, this is in keeping with the golden electrical rule of automotive HVAC mentioned before. The ECM keeps the final say on matters that draw power on the engine. The idea behind this study is to learn the flow of power and ground, and to understand who controls who. Oftentimes, when doing automotive HVAC diagnostics, the difficulty arises in analyzing the control structure of each component, whereby one component tends to control one leg of the relay coil, and others control the other side of it. As with anything automotive, practice makes for a better technician.